Hi, I'm Rick Emerson. It's the story of a man traveling across time and space, overcoming all manner of obstacles with the help of modern technology and scientific miracles. It is Star Pilot's Lament, and it's also the story of the creation of that album and the man behind it. Keelan King is our guest today on Outlook Portland on Northwest 32, which begins right now. Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. Throughout human history, music has adapted, evolved, and cross-pollinated all of the disparate forms, mixing together into kind of an amalgam, often creating something staggeringly new. One thing, however, remains a constant. The singer or the songwriter, the musician, the artist, in a room, in a studio, attempting a kind of artistic alchemy, trying to transform imagination into physical form, to capture on tape or on paper or on a hard drive what exists only as a kind of free-floating magic inside the creative center. Sometimes it can seem so amazing that it is utterly unbelievable that it manages to happen at all. This task has been aided immeasurably by advances in recording and sound technology, but at the center of it, all of it, it must begin with the idea. Today we'll speak with a Portland musician who has recently transferred such an idea from his own creative center to the realm of the real. His past albums include Soundtrack for an Automated Night and, as a member of Azure Noir, Addicted to Blue. His newest project is Star Pilot's Lament, a musical science fiction epic. To my immediate right, Mr. Keelan King. Hello, sir. Welcome to Outlook Portland.
Hello. Thank you.
And full disclosure, for those who are familiar with the Rick Emerson Show over the years, you've been a frequent guest contributor, ranter, pithy observer of the human condition.
Yeah.
And you have evolved and progressed through a lot of different kinds of music and a lot of different projects. Tell me a little bit about Star Pilot's Lament. Give us a sort of overview of that.
Well, basically, Star Pilot's Lament is a musical sci-fi epic, which is a blend of, let's say, electronic R&B with some hip hop undertones. One of the few times that I felt like a project should be told in a story and has to be done that way. So that was kind of the idea behind the project, is to put the album together, tell a story, but make sure that it all blends together and still do something that, as I feel to this date, hasn't actually been done before.
What was there a specific inspiration for it? Were you watching something or listening to something and suddenly the idea popped into your head and you said, I know what I must do?
Not specifically in terms of getting the idea. What it boiled down to for me is realizing that, okay, I love science fiction. I love a lot of television shows and movies that embody dozens of years of science fiction work, and I love making music. And until now, I haven't found a music genre or style that I felt is exactly me. So upon getting that idea, let's take the album. Let's do it in the style of music that I'm comfortable with. And one of the biggest problems that a lot of musicians have is, where am I going to get content? What am I going to write about? So instead of me coming up with the, you know, same four versions of a love song that everyone else does, I figured, hey, I love sci-fi, I love making music, let's put the two together and do exactly what I love to do.
Do you start with the music, do you start with the melody for the underlying music, or the melody for the vocals, or the hook, or is it just whatever happens to pop into your head?
Usually it's whatever pops into my head. A lot of times I'll end up arranging or rearranging certain sections. So say if I come up with a hook first, or a section that I think should be used for the hook, if I write a second section that goes along with it and I think, well, this works a little better, I'll just reverse the two, where that will all of a sudden become the verse and this will become the hook. But essentially what I do is I start with the melody or whatever instrumental piece or thought that's kind of hit my brain, and then I will lay in a bass drum and maybe another complementary part, and then go into layering drums after that, and then kind of flesh it out. And once you get that, you kind of have a skeleton, you have a framework for the song, and that'll allow you to go back and then add in any pieces that may accentuate certain areas.
All of this talking about swapping things around and moving things and picking up a piece and deciding it works better over here, none of that would be possible, or it would be much more difficult were it not for digital editing, digital recording. And it's worth noting that you did, I think, all of this yourself at a computer or at a couple of computers at your house.
Yes.
I mean, you did this all in one place.
Yes.
That's probably the only way that something like this is possible now. You probably would be very, very difficult to realize this financially, if not otherwise, without without the availability of digital media?
I think so. I think that's a very valid point. I have a lot of other friends that are musicians, but to put something together that is organic and has a story and fits together, it can be done because we've seen many bands that have put together their own concept albums. But to have that kind of fluid thought process of starting at the beginning, getting to the middle, and kind of writing at the end, almost like you would in a book, it does help to have a kind of digital process.
We're talking with Mr. Keelan King. His new project is Star Pilots Lament. You are watching Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV. Stay right there. We return momentarily. Go nowhere. Hi, I'm Rick Emerson here for Things from Another World, our marquee sponsor here at Outlook Portland. And when it comes to space odysseys, stories of every kind and variety, sagas of every size, shape, and type are waiting for you at Things from Another World. They've got three physical locations here in Portland, and they're available online at tfaw.com. That is tfaw.com. Whether it's comics, toys, games, collectibles, clothing, anything you need to satisfy your space journeying heart's desire. You can find them online at tfaw.com or, again, at their three physical locations in Portland. Please do tell them you heard about them right here at Outlook Portland. Things from Another World, tfaw.com or their three physical locations in Portland, tfaw.com. Things from Another World, whatever you're into, they have just the thing for your collection.